In this video, we're going to focus on how can I add array elements at the end of an array in JavaScript. And we're going to use Chartjs as a demo, because Chartjs has some challenges within itself, which is quite useful to learn and realize how it works. So for example, here we have this wonderful bar chart here. And what we want to do is we want to add up a new value at the very end. Imagine we have a new color putting at the end here, which is the color black. So how can we do this? Well, basically here, we have a few options what we can do. First thing what we need to do is we need to get the array value here. And to get this, if you would do like this, it's not possible. So let me show you exactly how we get it in the Chartjs. So let's say Chartjs, you can see here we're going to get data. And then from data sets, we go to the data here. Then you will see that even if we will get this, we will have an error. We get an error, and the main reason for the error is we didn't load yet the data. So you can see here, dot data. If I would say here now console.log, it will not give me a value at all. If I save this, refresh, it gives an error already. You can see here it doesn't work. Can I read the property data of undefined? Which is correct, because let's look at it. Chartjs is reading, or JavaScript will read all the codes first, and it reads this command here, which is referring to this variable here and then going down here, but we didn't load this yet, so it doesn't know that this exists. If we remove this and put it down here and save that and refresh, you see it works now, and then of course it gets an undefined. So let's see what's going on. Undefined, reason why it's data set, because this is here an array as well. So refresh this and do it again. There you are. So now if you do this, you can see here, we get all the values here. We see length of 6, and we can see all the values here. So how would we add up another value? Well, basically, you can add up a new value by using the command push. So let's say we have your push, and here we can push in a value, let's say number 10. If I save this now and refresh, you can see here, the 7th element is number 10, which is correct. However, here, what I want to do is not only to push, I want to get this, I want to push it, and then I want to show the array as well. So if I refresh here, you can see we have 7 elements, and if we click on this, we see number 10 here, and that's index number 6. That's correct, because it starts with index 0. However, if you look at the chart here, if I remove this, the chart doesn't show the next element, or the 7th element in here. And the reason why is because Chartjs doesn't yet read it because of the label that is missing. So what we could do basically is the following. Is basically add up the label. Oh, and of course, what I realized as well, it's not possible as well, because, well, the main reason for this is it already renders here the chart. So imagine this, if you have the array in here, but you want to adjust it, but you cannot adjust it within here and also not above. How can you solve this issue? Because right now, if you would add up here, let's say we push here data for the label. So we say here data label. That's label. So my chart data labels. And then we say here the color black. And then we put it in here label. This will work. Everything, but this of course will not render because it doesn't get these data here. So what we need to do is we need to move this data above here up, basically, but not in the console log, of course. And we cannot use this because this is forbidden, because this is based on this variable here. So what we need to do here is we need to create a new constant, and this constant will be, for example, called labels equals, and then that's this one here. The moment we have this here, then what we can do here is to push in labels. I'm going to copy this. We can just say labels.push. And then we say here the value will be black. So if I do this now, and I just comment this out, you will see that this will work if we copy the labels information here. Basically, the constant will be put in here. And I will just put it back, sorry. Here, and I refresh this. And there you are. So now we get the label, but of course we don't have the value of this. So what we have to do here, same story. We can do almost similar, but then what we do here is specifically for the data, I'm going to get this data here. I'm going to cut this out. I'm going to give this the value of data. It could be anything else you want. So the constant data equals this, and then we say data.push, and what will we push? Well, we push the value. This is not a string. Black was a string, but this one is a number. So we can say here number 10. And if I do this now, and I just copy this data here, or we already set it in here, save that, refresh. Now it works. Of course, the background color here has not been adjusted. We can do this quickly as well, but it's not necessary for now. I will ignore that. So what will happen is, if you don't have a background color here for black, it will loop through what's currently here. So what happens is, this is the values for the background color, and number 6, so the 6th value is this, and then number 7 doesn't exist here, so that would mean the number 7 will get this value here, which is the color red, and that's what you can see what's happening here in Chart.js. So, but this here basically is a way how you can add or push a value at the very end in an array, and with that you can incorporate that directly into Chart.js. And the reason why we're doing it like this here, because this is more common way. You're going to use probably this if you have JSON values or something like that. You get it from a database, you will work with this, and then you modify it, and then you will put it here. If you want to have some fun, what we can do as well, this is the final part that I think that's fun as well. Why don't we make a HR here with a button where we can create a onClick effect. So the moment we click on it, onClick, we want to push a value or add a value. So we say here, onClick equals push chart. This will be our function name. So I'm going to copy the function name here. Let me say here in JavaScript, create a function. It's the name pushChart, and this function will do basically this. The moment we click on it, we're going to add these items here. We'll cut this out, put it in here. There you are. Now if I refresh, oh, you can see I forget a button value. Add value. Once I do that, I click on this. Why it doesn't work, let me explain here, because in Chart.js you need to say here my chart.update. So why is this? Well, basically here my chart is the ID here of this canvas that we have here. We want to update the chart with the new values inserted. So once we refresh it and do this again, there you are. And now you can see here we have this, and we, as we add up, we push up consistently new values here. And this is the way how you can add a new value or new array elements in at the end of an array in JavaScript. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you enjoy it. And if you enjoy this video, you probably will enjoy this one as well. And if you're interested in Chart.js, check out in the description box the link directing to my Chart.js course, where you can learn everything about Chart.js. And finally, of course, make sure you subscribe to my channel.